This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And this is going to be an introduction to exponents. So let's get started. Let's say I've got a situation like this, where I've got the number 5, and I want to multiply it by itself 4 times. I want to multiply 5 times 5 times 5 times 5. Well, I could write it out like this, or I could use exponents and write it in a much simpler manner. Using exponents, I'm going to write the number 5, and then after it, and a little bit higher than it, I'm going to write a small number 4. That 4 is an exponent. The 5 is called the base for the exponent. So that's the base. And the 4 is the exponent. And what this notation means is that we take the number that's the base, the 5, and we multiply it repeatedly, in this case 4 times. The exponent tells us how many times we're multiplying it. So both of these notations mean the same thing. 5 times 5 times 5 times 5, I would multiply that out. Or I could just write 5 with the exponent 4 after it. Now let's take a moment and talk about how you're going to say this. Formally, if you've got a situation like this, a base of 5 and an exponent that's 4, you would say 5 raised to the 4th power. But most people don't say that much. They may say 5 raised to the 4th, or 5 to the 4th power, or just 5 to the 4th. All of those would mean the same thing. Now, if we're just multiplying something by itself 2 times, so in other words, 5 raised to the 2nd power, which of course would be 5 times 5, you may also hear people saying, calling this 5 squared. So when the exponent is a 2, people may just use the term squared after it instead of saying 5 to the 2nd. If the exponent is a 3, like 5 to the 3rd power, then people may say, instead of 5 to the 3rd, they may just say 5 cubed. Okay? So when the exponent is a 2, people may say squared instead of 5 or whatever to the 2nd. When it's a 3, they may say cubed, 5 cubed, instead of 5 to the 3rd. Okay? So let's just look at some examples and make sure we have a good handle on this. Okay, so here's 2 with an exponent of 5. That would be 2 to the 5th, or 2 raised to the 5th, or 2 to the 5th power. And that's just going to mean 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. I'm multiplying 2 repeatedly 5 times. We could multiply that out. 2 times 2 would be 4, times 2 more would be 8, times 2 more would be 16, and then times 2 again would be 32. If I have 3 to the 4th power, that would be the base, the 3, multiplied repeatedly 4 times. I know that from the exponent. So 3 times 3 would be 9, times 3 again would be 27, and times 3 again would be 81. I've got 7 to the 2nd power, or 7 squared. That's just 7 times 7, or 49. And here I've got 4 to the 3rd power, or 4 cubed. So that's 4 times 4 times 4. 4 times 4 would be 16, times 4 again would be 64. Okay, so that's your basic introduction to exponents. Take care. I'll see you next time.